Hello, and welcome to my first video for my video blog. This is probably not going to be the first video that I post, but this is my first one that I'm making because for this test, I'm actually wearing it now so I can demonstrate. So what we're going to go over today is Holter monitors. Keep in mind that I did not go to med school. I'm not always going to get the terminology 100% correct. I didn't study up on this. I'm just telling you based on my life experiences, based on what I have went through. So yes, I'm not always going to be right. So you're going to comment below and be like, look, that's not correct. Well, that's okay. I'm not here making these blogs so that you can study for exams. I'm making these blogs for people who have not gone through anything like this before and who maybe want to know from somebody else's point of view what it's like to go through this, what their experiences are, how it felt. Because a lot of times you may read up on it and they may give you all the facts, but different people experience things differently and you may not get a good feeling of what it's like to actually have the test done. So this is a blog about experience, not about like terminology, and I'm not going to school for this. I've just been dealing with this my entire life. So with that being said, I'm going to talk about Holter monitors today. Holter monitors are this test that they do. It's basically really easy. It's actually the second simplest test you will ever have done regarding your heart. It doesn't hurt, it's painless, and it's, you know, pretty simple and straightforward. So what they do with a Holter monitor is they attach a little machine to you, and it measures, or it actually records, it's like an EKG, it's a mobile EKG. So what it does is it records the way your heart beats, your rhythm, and in that, it will tell you whether you have PVCs, SVTs, PACs, any kind of weird palpitations or anything happening with the rhythm of your heart, arrhythmias, anything like that. I get palpitations a lot. They just put me on a blood pressure medicine. So my cardiologist wanted to be on the safe side and just get the Holter monitor done. I had this once before because I had a lot of stress going on, and he gave me a Holter monitor quite a few years ago, and they were going to do an oblation because I had a lot of SVTs, but when I went to get the oblation done, they were like, well, it's not an electrical problem with your heart, so we can't do the oblation. So again, I'm having palpitations and weird issues going on, so my cardiologist just wants to hook the Holter monitor up just to make sure. You wear the Holter monitor for 24 hours to 48 hours, usually. Mine's 24 hours, and it just basically checks the rhythm of your heart. So it's a fairly simple test. Basically, I'm going to show you. It is the size of it's the size of a beeper or a pager. If you used to, if anybody is old enough to know what a beeper or a pager is, that's basically the size of it. So here we have, it's simple and it's little and it can fit in your pocket. It's not big at all. So this has a wire hooked up to it, and the wire has leads, so it breaks off into like five different little wires, and they call those leads, and the leads attach to the electrodes that they put on your, so here you'll see an electrode. So they're circular, usually, sometimes they're square, and this is a lead, and it hooks up to the electrode. So it snaps just like a button. You're just gonna boop, snap it in, and these usually stay on people, but as you can see, I have them taped because I sweat sometimes, or because things happen and they come off. So I have mine taped, but you're going to have one here, 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 and then two on your sides. Basically just like getting an EKG. And you keep that thing in your pocket, and it's so simple, and nobody can even tell you have wires on. Nobody can tell what you're wearing, depending on the shirt that you're wearing. So it's pretty simple. And then you're going to wear it for 24 hours, and tonight I'll have to sleep in pajamas that have pockets. And then you go the next morning to your cardiologist and you turn it in. EKG is one of the simplest tests that you will ever have. This is the second simplest. The only thing that you're going to probably experience, you might experience some red irritation from where these electrodes were. I'm going to experience irritation from the tape because I always do. And then they might itch, you know, it, depending on how you take things and what your skin is like. But that's it. They're painless. They don't hurt. They shouldn't hurt. They're pretty simple. So if you have any questions, feel free to type below. I'm going to be making a lot more of these videos so that you can sort of get a feel of all the different tests that go on. And again, I'm making these videos based on experience, not on what I studied in a book. So I know some things are not going to be right or technical, but you could feel free to comment if you want to correct something or a term that I used that was wrong. Feel free to comment. I hope this helps somebody out, and I'm hoping that this blog maybe will give a person who doesn't know what it's like to go through these tests the experience and a little bit of insight on what it's like to have a test done. So that was Holter Monitors. Next time I'm probably going to be posting about echocardiograms. So look out for my next post. Thank you.